Welcome to Capital TV News. I'm Miano Mushiri, and these are the stories making headlines. Former Prime Minister Raila Odinga and former Vice President Kalonzo Musyoka will not be paid pensions until they quit politics. President Uhuru Kenyatta had refused to sign off on their pensions while they are still in active politics. The provisions of Coalition for Reforms and Democracy, of which the two are principles, failed to challenge on the floor of Parliament for lack of numbers. President Uhuru Kenyatta has directed that the curfew in North and Northern Eastern be lifted. President Kenyatta has further instructed the Interior Cabinet Secretary Joseph Kaiseri to enhance security throughout the country during this holy month. The head of state called on all Muslims countrywide to be vigilant and cooperate fully with security agencies during this period.
The security agencies will review all measures, including the current curfew, in the counties of Mandera, Wajir, Garissa, Lamu, and Tana River. In the same light, and aware that the enemies of our country may wish to exploit this season, I call upon the entire Muslim fraternity and its leadership to remain vigilant and do everything in their power to cooperate with the security agencies in order to safeguard this holy month.
President Kenyatta says 13 howlers will also have their suspensions lifted upon compliance with the central bank guidelines. He has therefore directed Central Bank to hastily issue those guidelines to guard against the transfer of funds to terrorists. The howlers were suspended following the Garissa University College attack, in which 148 were killed by terrorists.
I have also been briefed on progress in the ongoing investigations on the financing of terrorism. I have noted the proposal to lift the suspension of licenses for 13 registered money remittance providers. In the light of this, I direct the Central Bank of Kenya to immediately issue comprehensive regulations that guide the operations of MPRs upon which their suspension would be lifted.
The Cabinet Secretary of Devolution, Anne Waiguru, defended the NYS over reports of graft. Olive Barrows brings us the report.
She was in no laughing mood.
Musoku, let me be clear, because I think you're looking for a story. Let me be clear. Don't ask leading questions because you're looking for a story to write.
Her baby, the National Youth Service, had come under attack. And so she went to painstaking lengths to refute allegations that her ministry was involved in an attempt to defraud the Kenyan taxpayer of 826 million.
I am the one who wrote to the CID asking them to investigate transactions that had been reported in the IFMIS as being suspect.
And contrary to media reports, she said, all tenders issued by the ministry were above board.
Those who have been stopped from benefiting from the cartels that have long controlled the National Youth Service and crippled its functions are now fighting back and are trying to indicate that there is a problem.
In fact, the gentleman accused of being behind the said underhand deals she defended had actually saved the day.
He saw there were some transactions that happened over at night in the system. We used the IFMI system. And so he raised the flag immediately.
His appointment to the NYS, she said, was not motivated by a rift between her and NYS director Nelson Githinji.
As a matter of fact, we consult on lots of issues, both on WhatsApp and on SMS, on a continuous basis.
In case her demeanor hadn't been loud enough.
But we will not be coming every day. There is a story in the newspaper about NYS. That we wouldn't do again. We did it today because of the first time, and we care very much about the brand of the National Youth Service. Now, if another story comes out tomorrow, we will not come and call another press conference. The reason being, we cannot, on a daily basis, be responding to allegations.
In other news, police called a fatal shooting that killed at least 9 people on Wednesday in a historic church in Charleston a hate crime. Worshippers were attending a prayer meeting in the Emmanuel African Methodist Episcopal Church on Wednesday evening when the gunman walked in and opened fire. A white male suspect in his early 20s remained at large after the shooting. In business, suspended managing director of Kenya Airports Authority, Lucy Bogwa, says her suspension was wrong. She told the Parliamentary Committee on Transport that she was not involved in the awarding of the controversial tender for passenger transport vehicles at the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport. The move to send her and five other senior management staff home came barely a week after President Uhuru Kenyatta ordered the arrest of those involved in the leasing of the five-ramp passenger buses at 10 million shillings per month. And finally, in sports, Chilean football star Arturo Vidal has made a tearful apology after driving while drunk and crashing his Ferrari. He took responsibility for the accident, which left him and his wife with light injuries and mangled the driver's side of his red Ferrari. Vidal is currently the leading scorer in the Copa America, which kicked off last week. Today, we ask what your comments are on the Chad government's decision to ban Barkers in response to suicide bombers. And that's a wrap of your day's news. For more of these and other stories, log on to our website, www.capitalfm.co.ke/TV. I've been your host, Miana Mushiri. Don't forget to subscribe and like.